Would you, sir?
Okay, now am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Now is slide showing.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now let's come to the analysis part. If we see the racial prevalence of the healers, we find that there are different kinds of sect and racial people who are using these traditional knowledge for the traditions. And in the North Bengal, they are Rajbungsi, Mecho, Orano, and in the South Bengal, that Vaitya, Gunin, and mixed type of traditional healers are also there. In Jungle Mahal, we will find Bhumija, Maji, Bagdi, and the Vede. These are the actual racial different race who are doing this practice. Now come to the next point, the major steps they used by the traditional healers. In the Jungle Mahal, initially they used to diagnose through the fang marks. Then they start the differentiation of the fang marks, like if it is cobra, what will be the fang marks? If it is viper, that erotic lesions will be there, along with ecchymosis will be there. And if it is crate, then longitudinal two fang marks will be there. So they followed certain methodology. Not they are doing that, they are practicing as per the traditional way without knowing the things. And then their treatment start to this treatment. In the Jungle Mahal, they starts with first bandhana, then mantra. Mantra varies from different tradition to traditions. And then they used to assess the intermediate fatal assessment. Intermediately, they used to give some medicines. If that test bitter, the medicine is Sisam Pallas Parera, that is Patha. If it tests bitter, then they consider it at non-serious conditions, mean it is not so serious. If it is not bitter by test, then it is considered as serious. Means they used to give the root of Sisam Pallas Parera. Okay, next one is, next three points. First, we consider the first three points, when how they approach, then what is their identification of the marks. Third one is what they adopted as a treatment module. In fourth, what medicine they used to prescribe. That is, in the Jungle Mahal, most common used plant is root of Sisam Pallas and the Khichiri. Then normally after that they used to give some balamul and hibiscus rosa sinensis in the Brahma Talu. If it is this way is more than 4 or 5, according to them, if there is any loose motions or abdomen pain, then they start giving these hibiscus rosa sinensis, saving over the Brahma Talu and paste over that. That is the medicines. Then they used to manage four different kind of complications, like frothing from the mouth, then headache, then swelling in the leg, then in hematuria. In frothing from the mouth, they used to give that same plant and paste it and put it under the tongue. Then in headache, they use normally tamarindus water, that is tintidic quath, maybe you can say. And swelling in leg, they apply cow dung initially. After that, umber bell, that I will show you. Then paste the some ushiramul, like that. Then in Himachuria, they used durva. You know durva, synodontin, dactylon, and these plus ushira. Then in the viper bite, in long-term treatment, in the viper bite, they used to give CP, that is Patha, for 250 milligram with Gogrita BD for 10 days. That is the major protocol adopted by the Jungle Mahal traditional healers. Next, the North Bengal, they also used to diagnose with fang marks. Then differentiation marks, they consider on the basis of swelling and bleeding. And in the, whereas the Jungle Mahal, their identification marks was differentiated according to the fang marks only. And here in the North Bengal, their module are sequentially different. In the Jungle Mahal, it was first bandhana, then mantra. Here first they start with mantra, which varies in the different traditions, then bandhana. And sometimes they used to give the bandhana, that is Arishta bandhana. We will discuss in later slide. I am going fast because I am taking the time of others. people. So then not with mantra, then intermediate fatal sign, there is no intermediate fatal assessment whether the case is going to fatal or not. There is no kind of essence. Next, medicines, usually they will give Ishwarmul, that I will sow the plants and along with the parts of use. Then if there is frothing of mouth, they adopted some kind of this protocol. What I would like to say, that each and every aspects of their treatment, they used to follow certain kind of methodology, which is a standard methodology, and they adopt the plants which are available in their vicinity. Though it differ from the North Bengal or South Bengal or Jangal Mahal, they used a different type of therapy. So in headache, in the previously they in the Jangal Mahal they used Tintadika Kasayam. Here they used Bilvamula Paniya and Grithar. Due to the climatic variation in the different parts, like in the North Bengal and Jangal Mahal is a dry area, or maybe the humidity is less, but in North Bengal the temperature is cool. So that is why the difference is found. And according to the features, they used to give long treatment. So this is the protocol what we have designed, and according to this protocol, we have taken their survey. So in the South Bengal, whereas we see the blister formations is the main identifying mark, along with the fang marks. Fang marks is the diagnostic point, then blister formation. After that treatment, first they used to apply one copper coin over the beaten area. Then if it is sticked, then they consider it is poisonous. Then after that, they used lemon over the beaten area. Then mantra. After that come mantra, then bandage. So first they used to assess one assessment. There is no intermediate assessment in this parampara, in these traditions. So in the South Bengal also, they adopt most of these same kind of measurement what adopted by the North Bengal people, mostly the Ishwarmul. Here also they used Ishwarmul. And in headache, they used coconut water. Or in frothing from mouth, they used Usirmul and Lajapaniyam. Usir and Lajapaniyam. Now we will go to the next analytical point, which is ethnobotanical aspects. So if we see the mantra aspect, if we analyze from the classical point of view, there are so many references of the mantra, and that is why we can understand that whatever they are doing, they are justifying the classical knowledge and wisdom into the clinical practice. Now we are not adept in this knowledge that we can be able to give some kind of benefit with the mantra, because our mantra is not Siddhya. So in the classical text, it says the Siddha mantra is the tool. And in the initial Vega, Vega 1 and 2, Siddha mantra can be given. And in always in the snake bite, it is given because it is mentioned in the first. That is why Siddha mantra is justified. And in Arishtavandan also, you can see in the Arishtavandan, in the Sakha Darshta, this snake used to bite in the Sakha, means in the limbs. So in the snake bites condition, we can use Arishtavandan as per classical text, and it will prevent the onward propagation of the dosha to the deeper dhatu. And in dosha avastha also, initial phase, it is given, and they are also giving, the traditional healer also used to give these in this initial phase. That is what I am showing is they are using the classical wealth and classical wisdom. And what they used to apply on these limbs as a knot is their towels, which is prepared on cotton or any kind of soft material. In text it says any non-cutting thread will be there. So pharmacological therapy, they used five different kinds of medicines. Different one is external, another is internal. In internal, they used Rakta Sodaka, then Hridya, then Rasoposaka, and after that they used Prativisha, means that antidote, specific antidote for specific snake or specific things. Then Jivaniya. So raktasadak, riddhya, raktaposhaka, prativisha and jivaniya are the medicine they used and the labor. And some folklore practitioners, they used some minerals, little bit minerals like borax, tankana, gold, copper, mica and red chalk, that is gairika, tambra and abra. And some formulations, some traditional sellers who are little bit advanced, they used some kind of formula. Like in Vishwanasak Yog, they used Pathadi Jog. And in Raktoposhak, they used Manjishta or Sarapunkha. Then in Samanya, they used Guduchi, Anantamula or Dhataki. And follow-up medicine, they used Sarivadi Jog, who is contained Sariva, Nimba and Tintidikam. I am using the classical name only. Next, in the total plant, I will show just a glimpse. Only 54 plant they have mentioned in the what we found in this survey, 54 plant within of which we are just showing you only 42 plants. The first one is that is Ankod or Bandha Ankod in Bengali, and it is Alangium, and main useful parts is root or root bark, and preparation it is given preparing as a paste, and sometimes it is given orally in viper bite or as an external applications. And Patha or Aknadi in Bengal, it is called Aknadi, and Sisampelas, and roots, sometimes roots is given and sometimes whole plant is given. So roots, it is used as a for testing of poison, as I told. If it tastes bitter, then it is, they consider it as non-poison, non-poisonous, or poisoning condition is not so grave, or if it is test is okay, then root for remedy. Throughout the treatment in the Jungle Mahal, they used this plant. Next one is Tylophora, that is Anantamul.
Please conclude soon, sir.
Okay. So these are the plants. Okay, then Almora, then Bada Koduchi, that is, and these are the algae marmelas, then Andrographis, then Dhova, then Chaturmukhi, Chitraga, Dayalkushi. Dayalkushi is used in the North Bengal. Then Dhuli Kadamba, then Dhekiya Sak. This is used for only the mantra uccharan or Bisha Dheki. Then Durva, then Tinospora, and this is Isar Mool, Alastolochi Endiga. This is used in most of the cases in the North Bengal and South Bengal as well. And Kalkasunda, Jinti, it is Parleria cristata. Then Kalmeg, Andrographis, and the Kapal Putalota, that is very important, that is used in the South Bengal also. And Kitmar, and Krishna Chuda used in externally. Then Kunch, that is Gunja, Abras picatorias. So I'm concluding this. So this survey should be what I want to convey, this that survey should be continuous in a regular basis, and it is beginning of what I have done. As per my knowledge of 6 years with them, I have found that my survey is very, very less. So it should continue, and classical evaluation should be there in each and every juncture for evaluating their justifications, and new formula should be testified and incorporated in practice. That is very, very important. I want to focus. We should adopt this, all these new formula, and we should incorporate it within our text, means within our practice. If you practice it, then it will be transmitted in the next generation. So their practice are to be restored as per rule. So that I told in the beginning, that some rules and regulations are restricting them to practice. So we should protect them as per the rule, so that this golden parampara should be continued. Thank you.